Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is that, O Lord, O energy of Lord Hare, Radharani, please engage me in the service of Krishna. And this satisfies him completely. And then we develop our relationship with him. That's it. Then all happiness, all blessings automatically descend on us. The name of the Lord is not different from the Lord. And once we have the holy name with us and we're chanting, that will manifest all wonderful things. Gradually, this golden age is manifesting. It will manifest. More people chant Hare Krishna mantra. More we are all engaging cooperatively in serving the Lord. You will find this manifestation. And Srila Prabhupada said, if even 1% of the population of a place, if they become devotees, chant Hare Krishna and all that, golden age will manifest more prominently. You know, what is golden age? That everything, there will be peace, prosperity. People won't have negative thoughts. Everybody is very positive. Not, you know, these anger, hatred, jealousy. These things won't be there. Everybody is very pious, very loving, caring. So this golden age communities will manifest from following the instructions and method of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we need to know, we need to familiarize ourselves with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and what his instructions are for this modern age. So very simple, he has given us, and then he said congregational chanting, chanting together. See, normally we have this idea, spiritual life means we have to give up our friends, family, go separately somewhere, and then try to concentrate, meditate, and so on, isn't it? That's why people are afraid of spiritual life. That means I have to put an end to all my material connections and all that, and then go away. I should give up all my, home, my possessions. And this is the idea. So, but in this age, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, no. Griheta ko vaneta ko sada hari bolida ko. It doesn't matter whether you stay in your home or you go to the forest, it makes no difference. The most important thing is that you need to chant Hare Krishna. And how is it very effective? Congregation, together when we chant, it's very, very powerful. It's like a big yajna. You know, like in earlier times, they used to have this Ashwamedha yajna, Gomedha. You hear of big yajnas being done by big kings, and then for days they would come and have a lot of sacrifice of grains and ghee and chanting of mantras by very pure brahmanas. And the Lord would come out of the fire sometimes. You know, when he is very satisfied, the Lord will appear from the fire. And then you know, oh, perfect yajna. And so in this age, we don't have so much resources or people qualified to chant those mantras. And so when you chant together Hare Krishna Maha Mantra very sincerely, that is equal, that will give you the same results. Isn't that wonderful? So many people have experienced different miracles through chanting Hare Krishna mantra congregationally. You know, there was there were farmers in Andhra Pradesh some years ago in India, Andhra Pradesh. They had a drought. When was it? I think in the late 1990s. Okay, they had a drought, and all the farmers, they went in one particular village, one devotee's village. And they were singing bhajans for 9 days, but mostly all Hare Krishna kirtan, mostly because he introduced them. And for 9 days they were chanting that. And at the end of that, only in that village, there were heavy rains. And they had a bumper crop that year, chilies. They were growing crores of rupees. They got profit, not in the other villages, only there, because they performed the Sankirtana Yajna. And also, there were, around the same time, there were earthquakes in Maharashtra. A row of villages, you know, even in Gujarat and all that, there were heavy earthquakes, and whole villages were destroyed, houses broken, and people evacuating the place and all that. And only in two villages, Latur, you know, two villages in the middle of that, nothing happened. So they asked, what is the reason? And the devotees said, every week devotees were going and performing Sankirtan there. So they were protected. And even in Gujarat, in Kutch and all that, there was heavy earthquakes, I mean destruction of the homes. But whoever was chanting Hare Krishna, you know, their homes were intact. In so many ways you can see how Hare Krishna mantra is protecting us. It works. So, very easy method. If you ask people who are chanting Hare Krishna, tell me what miracles you have experienced, what protection, mercy you've experienced, everyone will have something to say. You know, amazing. There was one girl who was chanting Hare Krishna for some time, with the 16 rounds, and then everything was fine with her life, and then she left. She was stopped coming. But one day, what happened, I suddenly got a call from her, and she said, oh my God, just now what happened? I had gone in the car, she was learning car driving, and the driver, in the Middle East, he just took her to a lonely spot, and he stopped it. And she got frightened, what is he going to do? And at that time, she just got out of the car, and she remembered the Hare Krishna mantra. It was a very lonely spot. There was nobody around there. And she just shouted out the holy names. She didn't know what's going on. She just cried out to the Lord. And at that time, suddenly one car passed by. And this driver got scared and he left. And she called me, see, I stopped coming. But now Krishna showed me how powerful is the Hare Krishna mantra. How we need to chant. So, and also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed what is the kind of community that develops when people are chanting Hare Krishna together. It's not that they just, they develop very loving relationships, close bonding, very concerned about each other. You know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to advise, there was one devotee called Vasudeva Datta, very exalted devotee. But what he would do was, whenever every month he earned the money, he would just spend it off. You know, he was not saving, and he had his family and all. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he called Shivananda Sen, he's a businessman, good in managing, you know, finance and all that. He told him, no, you look at his finances and help him. This is not the way, he's a grihastha, he should save some money. So that way, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was also concerned about people's lives. He was helping and he made devotees take care of each other. And Srivastakur, he was he's actually the incarnation of Narad Muni. He's an associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he made Vasudeva and his family stay within his, you know, compound. So this is the kind of relationships where there was so much care. When one devotee called Krishna Das, he had actually gone along with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu on a tour to South India. He was carrying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pot and so on, and he was going with them. And then when they came to Kerala, there were some people called Bhattatharis, who are externally like sannyasis, and they wanted to steal Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's servant from them. So the Lord was resting in a temple of Lord Ramachandra, and that time in the middle of the night they sent some girls to lure the servant. And he was a very simple person. So when they called him, he just followed them. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became aware of that and he followed. And when he went there, he told the Bhattataris, what are you doing? You're also sannyasis, I'm also a sannyasi. Why are you trying to harm me? Why are you trying to take away my servant? And so these Bhattataris attacked Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with weapons. And of course, while the Lord's mystic power, the weapons went back and started chopping off their arms and all that. So they got terrified and left. And meanwhile, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pulled the shikha of Krishna Das, and took him along. He didn't say anything about it during his way back. But when he reached Orissa, Puri, he told the devotees, I don't want Krishna Das to serve me anymore. Because it was a major fall. He was right with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he went away like that. So the Lord said, I don't want to. And he was crying very bitterly, Krishna Das. And he said, how can I be without serving the Lord? That is the lifeline, right, for a devotee. Without serving the Lord, there is no connection. So he was very, very, sad that he had committed the mistake and he didn't know what to do. And the devotees got together and thought we should make Krishna Das. So they went and told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know what? Somebody needs to go to Orissa and tell your mother and all the devotees about your arrival back from the South India tour. Shall we send someone? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, yeah, send anyone. So they sent this Krishna Das. So they kept him at the service. So the whole community is concerned about each individual. Even if they have a temporary setback, some fall down, some mistake. Everybody is prone to commit mistakes, right? In this material world, because Maya is very strong. But it is the soldiers of Krishna, of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who have to protect one another. We see in the battlefield, what's the kind of relationships even the soldiers have. Right now, they are facing life and death, any moment, every day. They are facing death, any time it could attack. And so, the kind of bonding that the soldiers have is tremendous, especially the Indian soldiers. They have a lot of patriotism and the feeling, the Kshatriya spirit. They are ready to give up their life for the sake of the country. We can't even imagine. Giving up their life, their families, everything for the sake of their country. And if they have to survive, they have to help one another. You can't just say, okay, I'll just take care, I don't mind if he dies. No. They have to together see to each other's well-being. Then they can be successful. And they are very much, they have their feet on the ground. There is no showing off and trying to pretend that I'm a better soldier than you. Nothing like that. That is because you see life as it is, and such wonderful.